Today I wanted to talk about the energies for September. We are now on September 2nd, 2020. And if you have been tuning in to my YouTube videos before, you know around the first of the month, I always like to give a little hint of what's in store for us based on numerology and the tarot. And so numerology, September is a 9 month and 2020 is a 4 year. And the way we get the information is by adding all the numbers together. 2020, if you add those numbers together, you get 4. And then if you add the 9 and the 4 together, the 9 for September and the 4 for the year, you get 13. So in the tarot, the 13 card is the death card. Now, a lot of people are scared when they see the death card and they're worried about death. But in the tarot, the death card is not as scary as you may think. Now, very seldom does death card actually mean physical death, although, you know, that's always a possibility. We have seen a lot of death this year and we are in a 4 year, so there's, you know, there's a little bit of that energy going on. But death is more about transformation and it's about surrender. And so when we think about death, we think about a transition from one experience to another one. So if you think about physical death, when you pass on from this life to the next, you're leaving an experience of consciousness in the earth realm and you're going on to whatever's next. And so symbolically, the death card is about transition. This month, we are going to be transitioning into the next phase of energy that will start up in October. So it's going to be a month of kind of slowing down, of letting go of things that are no longer healthy or beneficial in your life. It might be a good month to do some self-inventory and decide what things are no longer life to me, what things are not beneficial to me any longer. Now, if you don't do it consciously and with intent, sometimes situations happen that will create the experience of you finding it necessary to do that without your intention. And so sometimes that's just the way life goes. If we don't take life by the horns and decide, okay, I'm going to deal with these issues, I'm going to release things that are no longer healthy, then circumstances seem to bring an experience of finding it necessary to do those things. So this month, it's really important to think about, what do I need to let go of? And make sure you let go of those things with love. Make sure that you're not holding on to things that are not healthy for you. Now, collectively, we may see that being the case because this is a collective number. But also individually, in your own individual life, it's really important to look at those things that you've really been holding on to and those things that you haven't been wanting to let go of. So I want you to really be thinking about that. What things do you need to release? What ideas about the state of the world? What ideas about even political views or, you know, religious views or personal point viewpoints? Some things we really need to examine and decide, are these things really healthy? Are they beneficial? Are they kind? Are they loving? So the next card that I want to bring up is the Emperor card. Now this is the 4 card in the tarot. And if you add the 1 and the 3 together from 13 that we talked about, then you get 4. The Emperor card is a card of discipline, rules, authority, and having things in a neat little box. And so 4 energy is all about power and authority and rules, regulations, those kind of things. So we might see a lot of transitions happening amongst people who are in positions of power. Now, we have an election coming up in the U.S., so those things might come out. I'm sure they're going to be out in the forefront. There might be some shifts this month that we aren't expecting to see. Who knows? But if not, anybody who is in a position of authority is going to be called to a place of transition. They're going to be called to let go of the power if they are wielding it in an unhealthy way. They're going to be called to really examine how they are wielding power. And even we on a personal level, we are going to be called to think about our own personal power, to think about the authority that we have in our own lives and in the lives of people around us, and how we are using that authority, whether we are using it with character, and whether we're using it in the most beneficial way possible for the people around us and for our own lives. So this month, I really want you to do some examining in those areas. What things do I need to surrender? What do I need to let go of? What's not healthy in my life? And in the other hand, what is something that I need to think about in the area of personal power, the power around me, the power that I give to others, the power that I hold within myself? And in the national and world realm, we just might see a lot of power plays coming up. There's a lot of planets in retrograde, which I'm not an astrologer, but this month is just a really going to be a tumultuous month, I think, and a month of us really finding it necessary to surrender our ideas of what we think should happen, of how we think the world should be going, and think about power and how that means something to us personally and collectively as a human race. I hope you enjoyed this little chat today, and I will see you next Wednesday.